how you climb the hill of Kwaio.
Yes.
In a hidden paradise of the South Pacific archipelago lies 992 islands. The Melanesian nation of Solomon Islands, stretching 900 miles across the Pacific Ocean, falls to the west of Fiji and northeast of Australia. Its main islands are Choiseul, Santa Isabel, San Cristobal, Malaita, New Georgia, and Guadalcanal. The capital city is Honiara. Solomon Islands has diverse cultures, languages, and customs. Most people reside in small, widely dispersed settlements along the coast. The majority of the people in Solomon Islands are Christians, 5% of the population are still unreached with the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ.
1991, we've heard about Kwaio people. And we were told the name Kwaio means kill. It didn't give me some kind of feeling like to be inferior, because we were asked and we were told, we were sent from Fiji to reach the Solomon Islands with the gospel of Jesus Christ to every people, to every tribes, every time, in every homes, knocking on doors day and night. It took us 3 days to go up to the mountain, to the border called Bobota. And we tried to go there and find people, because they are nomad. They didn't stay in one place for a long time. There were no such house that like we have here. It was a big challenge. It was a big thing to reach those people by the gospel of Jesus Christ. And after we have that mission, we have that breakthrough, we started the first church in Bobota. And right now, their mission and other things that's taking place after we have left in 1991.
Missionaries were sent from Fiji to the Solomon Islands to establish mission work in the province of Malaita among the Kwaio people. Kwaio, an ethnic group found in central Malaita, is remote and mountainous, having limited infrastructure, with paths leading to villages along the coast and through the thick forests. These unreached people's groups have very little foreign contact with the outside world. Their lifestyle is deeply confined to traditional norms, where spiritualism and sorcery is widely practiced.
Six of us, Joelle, Winnie, Kali, myself, with Tima and Alisi, to serve in the district of Uru Sinaragu and Oloburi in East Malaita in Kwaio.
The preaching of the gospel saw lives being saved. Amongst the newly converted, the provincial high priest, Radberry, gave his life to the Lord Jesus Christ. It was he who donated the piece of land in the highlands of Kwaio to the Fiji missionaries to facilitate their mission work.
This land I'm giving to you, give to you, Sakisa, for this mission, for mission, before they die.
15 years later, one of the six missionaries sent in 1994 was commissioned in 2010 by Christian Mission Fellowship International to establish the very first CMF International Church in the Hills of Kwaio.
This is how we climb up the steep mountains in Kwaio. It is not easy to take the gospel over this land. It takes a sacrifice and also the passion which enable you to carry the gospel over the land of Kwaio. But we thank you for your prayers and your giving, and we also thank you for forgetting us, as God to give us the determination and perseverance in order just to reach another soul for Christ in this land. I reached here 4 days ago, taking 5 days today. Spent 5 days with landowners here. And we are about 3,000 meters above sea level from where I'm standing now. And the life here is so cold, as you see, a fog is falling. And we have been experiencing cold weather all the day long. But we thank the Lord that the mission has been accomplished. Thank you for all those who are praying for Kwaio, praying for the work in East Kwaio.
The people of the Kwaio Hills have openly embraced the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ and have a great need for development and spiritual mentoring. Pastor Sekusa and his team have built a primary school, a church, and a clinic, all for the glory of God.
And we share the clothes to the hidden people. We share the Bible. We share also the radio for them to hear the gospel and gospel songs. And we want to thank you for all your gifts. Those who have contributed money and things you have given for this special mission trip as we came. Tape to hear the gospel around the wilderness and in the East Kwaio, because no battery, so they used this to hear the song of the glorifying Jesus and also the gospel of Jesus Christ. Thank you. Thank you very much for sending this radio, that we able to hear the voice of Reverend Julius Kurulo in Kwaio.
He always very critical and judgmental. He always accused them. Or do you always take time to pray for them? And allow God to break your heart with the very things that break his heart. Jeff Elliott once said, he is no fool who gives what he cannot keep.
Please pray for continuous strength for our Christian Kwaio brothers and sisters and the missionaries who are doing tremendous work in demonstrating the love of God through the two hands of the gospel.
And our prayer that East Kwaio and also the people living around here in Ocean Bata will be a source of blessing to your life, as what you have given for the work of God. We all love you and we all bless you, and long live everyone.